All right, what's up guys? Matt here from Loon Outdoors and we're back with another tailgate talk, as you can see. Today we're talking about a method of fishing for both trout and bass that has become highly effective here in Northern California and pretty much anywhere that you fish. What we're talking today is float and fly. At its most basic steps, you have a float and a fly. So during the winter months, what really ends up happening with a lot of our fish, obviously bass as well, is they become very sluggish, they slow down, and they're not as eager to run around, chase baits, and be as much fun as they are in the spring and summer months. Up here, there's been a handful of guides who have been fine-tuning this process. One of the best things that we have found is this isn't something that you have the $120,000 bass boat to do. If you have a kayak, a float tube, just like a little dinghy, fishing vessel that you have, even if you're fishing from shore, this is a kind of a cool tactic that you can use, say if the river's blown out, to go to a local reservoir and try catching some bass, and in our area, actually really big trout. It's a lot like nymph fishing. It's not gonna surprise you, there's not gonna be some new big whiz-bang thing that you have to buy. There's some small stuff and some certain styles of flies that end up working really, really well. You have a rod that you can nymph with, 6 or 7 weight, you're stoked. I do like a little bit longer of a rod. Casting is not like, you don't need to cast like 500 feet. The crazy part about this whole program is that we're fishing really proximal to the bank. We're fishing a lot of shade lines and we're fishing a lot of rock structure on steep ledges. The 7 weight gives you that backbone because we do catch some bass up to 5 pounds. I mean, they're big, they have big mouths and they eat things. Even though we're throwing small flies, you catch big fish. And I'm just using a nymph line. A nymph line for nymphs and indicators. So again, I have this cool little like 2 to 3 foot butt section of some 30 pound. And then I go into a float. Now floats are gonna be something that's super personal to each guy. For me, I have found this little lake float that I use to fish crowley in the Sierras. Use yarn, anything that you have just to get out there. Really the point's just getting out there. So from my butt section, I go to my indicator and I'm just running some 10 pound test. You know, guys are catching 10, 12 pound bass on 10 pound tests. So I feel fairly confident with the pressure that I'm able to put on the rod that I'm not gonna snap off. You know, it's a good idea always to check your leader after so many fish. So from there, this is a long, long, long leader. This leader goes really far. So I'm kind of like a big dude. I'm 6'1". I have a 6'3" wingspan. I do 3 pulls off the tippet spool. I like to say that's my 18-foot leader. From there, I'm going into a micro swivel. And then from the micro swivel, I'm going into, you know, 2 to 3 feet of tippet material, typically 3X, so 8 pound. These fish are not leader shy. Sometimes in this mix though, obviously you can see there's a fly on the bottom here. A lot of times I'll come right in the middle here and put a weightless fly. All of a sudden the fish are keen on this weird brown woolly buggery thing and maybe they think it's a crawdad, whatever it might be. But if they're getting happy on that, we might go to a double fly rig if once you see what's really happening. The flies for this are fairly simplistic. You can see this is just a cool little bait fish pattern. It happens to be on like a size 2 or 4 jig hook. I have a 4.5 mil tungsten bead on there. I have a non-lead underbody and it's really just some white and some olive. I glued some eyes on there using UV resin and you can see I kind of made it some shad colors. Sky's the limit here. The real reason that this technique works is the fish's metabolism. Trout, they're gonna be cruising the bank. They're happy in 50, 40 degree water. They're totally chill. Bass, on the other hand, become very sluggish. They'll sit on the bottom. And the way that we're presenting this is we're probably 20 feet from the bank. You throw in and you get your flies to land right on the bank. And we're fishing steeper banks and ledges, kind of like I said. And you're just letting that fly cruise down, slowly fall, and then it can just suspend. So if the bass are not moving and being super active, blasting around, racing out to eat things, chasing shad, the shad aren't moving as well. The bait fish, the forage is lethargic as well. So if you came in there and you're the meat bro, and you're just stripping streamers super aggressively, that fish isn't gonna take the time or effort to chase that down because it's not a guaranteed meal. Where the floating fly is just kind of this weak kind of, oh man, I'm tired and lethargic too, comes cruising down and lands next to him. And he goes, oh yeah, I'm gonna chow this dude. So it's a lot easier for him to relate to that type of movement to gain his dinner. So thanks for watching, guys. We'll catch you next time, and take care. GoPro, stop recording.